Rocket launches are very loud. If you ever get a chance to experience a rocket launch, you should never miss it. You can feel the vibration of rocket penetrating through the atmosphere and the loudness of it, even if you are standing many kilometers away from the actual launch site. If you are near the launch site, the sound will not rupture your eardrums, but it also can kill you. As engine exhaust gas exceeds the speed of sound, they collide with the ambient air molecules and shock waves are created, with the noise level approaching 200 decibel, which is very loud. This energy can be reflected from the launch platform and could potentially cause damage to the launch vehicle or payload, crew, and even the nearby buildings. There is a huge heat generation from the rocket nozzle and can also cause fire in the nearby buildings. Data from the launch of STS-1 found an overpressure wave was created by the shuttle's engine, which contributed to the loss of 16 and damage to an additional of 148 thermal protection tiles. Therefore, it is very necessary to reduce the sound or acoustic energy as much as possible. NASA did the modification of the sound suppression water system. Sites for launching larger rockets are often equipped with the sound suppression system to absorb or deflect acoustic energy generated during a rocket launch. Sound is dissipated by the huge volume of water distributed across the launch pad during a liftoff. They aid not only in reducing acoustic energy but also protecting nearby buildings from catching fire by injecting large quantity of water on the launch pad. Along with the enormous spray of water, NASA also used water bags at the bottom of solid rocket boosters to further dampen the shock wave. These were large nylon bags filled with water and stretched along the flame holes of SRBs. As the sound wave from the engine meets the water molecule, they start vibrating, converting sound energy into heat energy. The massive white cloud below and around the rocket at the time of launch is not smoke, but wet steam generated as the rocket exhaust boiled away huge quantity of water. We really cannot see the whole suppression system in action, but recently NASA conducted a test in which the system is capable of pouring 1 million liters of water in just 41 seconds. The sound suppression water system can reduce the sound from 200 decibel to more respectable 142 decibel, equivalent to a sound generated by the fighter aircraft. NASA also designed flame deflectors or flame trenches, not only to guide the rocket exhaust away from the launch pad, but also redirect the acoustic energy away. The flame deflector system includes an inverted V shape, which is made up of steel structure and covered with 5-inch thick, high-temperature concrete material, which will deflect hot flames and sound energy away from the rocket and nearby buildings. On the other hand, Russia does not use water-based suppression system because the temperature around the launch site is mostly below 0 degrees Celsius. So at low temperature, water will freeze and will not be able to flow through the system. They have designed the launch pad in a different way. The launch pad is above a large hole, similar to the flame deflector. So there is much more space for the rocket exhaust to get deflected outside in such a manner that the acoustic pressure is lot lower on the rocket. So today we saw different systems to dampen the acoustic energy. So thank you for watching and keep learning.
Trunk deploy.